Are you a grader working on ENERGY STAR certified homes? Great, then watch this short presentation to get you started with the latest improvements to the program called Revision 8. We'll cover three topics. First, the top changes you need to be aware of as a rater. Second, the updated process for certifying a home and the role you'll play. And third, next steps, including additional resources to help you succeed. Let's get started. To begin, let's discuss the top changes you need to be aware of in Revision 8 as a rater. First, to simplify the program, we've eliminated the prescriptive path. Going forward, all homes will be certified using the performance path. Second, let's talk about the rater inspection checklist. The thermal enclosure system and HVAC system rater checklist have been split into two documents. The Rater Design Review Checklist contains all of the items the rater can complete at the design stage. It's just half a page. The Rater Field Checklist contains all of the items to be completed in the field. It is one page front and back. And let's take a closer look at the Rater Field Checklist. The front of the Rater Field Checklist contains the requirements for the thermal enclosure system. Overall, there are no major changes to the requirements in this section. We have combined some items, removed a handful of less common items, and clarified the terminology regarding fully aligned air barriers. The back of the Rater Field Checklist contains the requirements for the HVAC system and includes some important changes. We streamlined the rater tasks and items related to testing and balancing, refrigerant charge math, and checking the heating, cooling, and fan mode have been removed, among others. We've combined all of the duct requirements into one section. We've provided higher duct leakage limits for systems serving small spaces and systems with three or more returns, and a pressure balancing limit of 5 pascals instead of 3 for bedrooms with a design airflow of greater than 150 CFM. We've grouped all of the whole house ventilation requirements into one section, updated the tolerances for airflow measurement, and simplified the requirements for air inlets. We've also grouped all the local mechanical exhaust requirements into one section, and have made the sound limits a recommendation rather than a requirement for most fans. Let's move on to the updated process for certifying a home and the role you'll play. At the design stage, you'll complete the Rater Design Review Checklist. Among other tasks, you'll review the HVAC design. With Revision 8, the HVAC System QI Contractor Checklist has also been split into two documents, the HVAC Design Report and the HVAC Commissioning Checklist. So to review the HVAC design, you'll need to collect the HVAC Design Report. But this is the only design document you'll typically need. You'll no longer have to collect the full load calculations, the air dry certificate, or separate documents for the ventilation design or for air balancing. Once construction begins, you'll complete the Rater Field Checklist. Prior to final inspection, the HVAC contractor will complete the HVAC Commissioning Checklist. With Revision 8, however, you're permitted but not required to collect this checklist for the home to be certified. Finally, the builder requirements and the Water Management System Builder Checklist have stayed mostly unchanged, but the builder will no longer have to fill out the checklist for each certified home, nor will the rater have to collect any documentation. This should give you a head start on Revision 8, but we've just scratched the surface. Now let's talk about next steps. Get the Revision 8 program documents by downloading them from EPA's website. Review the Revision 8 highlights document and crosswalk document to better understand what's changed. Most importantly, attend an upcoming webinar. There's much more to learn about Revision 8. And ask questions by writing to us here. Thanks for watching and for your support of the ENERGY STAR program.